Today we're talking about my minimalist pocket 4K camera rig, but first, if you're new to the channel, my name is Anson, and on this channel we talk about filmmaking gear, specifically gear for the budget-conscious filmmaker. So if that's you, consider subscribing. Now, I've already posted a camera rig tour for the Pocket 4K a couple months ago, but since then I've made some adjustments to the rig, and I want to talk about what those adjustments are, why I made those changes, and why I prefer this rig over the one I did a couple months ago. So without further ado, let's dive into it, starting first with the core of the rig. The core of the rig hasn't really changed all that much. I'm still using a Tilta full cage. I'm also using an HDMI right angle adapter from Tilta so that I can plug the HDMI cable towards the back of the camera rather than to the side. Now, one adjustment that I've made to the core is I've actually put the Pocket 4K on rods. And so I actually have a small rig base plate that holds 15 millimeter rods. And I usually go between 8 to 12 inches as far as the length of those rods, depending on how minimalist I actually want to be. And those are small rig rods as well. From there, I do still have my Tilta top handle, but I've actually reversed the grip. I find this is a lot easier to balance with larger lenses like my Sigma 50 to 100 or even 18 to 35. And on the Tilta handle, I actually have mounted my NPF plate from Tilta as well. That's actually how my Pocket 4K is now being powered, is through the NPF plate. If you saw my video a couple months ago, I was powering it through NPF still, but it was coming from the Tilta side handle. I've actually gotten rid of the side handle for my minimalist handheld rig just because it wasn't balanced. It just added a lot more weight on the left side of the camera, and so I took it off completely and put it on my shoulder rig, which I may talk about my shoulder rig eventually, but for the handheld rig, it is using the NPF base plate from Tilta, and that's being mounted to the logo side of the Tilta top handle. And so you can see it's actually towards the back of the camera, which helps it be balanced really well. I've actually really enjoyed the setup because of how balanced it is. Now, since I got rid of the side handle as well, I actually started using the Tilta SSD holder specifically for the Samsung T5. That is also mounted at the top of the cage as well, next to the top handle. Now, something to note is, generally speaking, when you're putting that SSD holder on the top of the cage, put the SSD holder on first and then the top handle. I found that if you put the top handle on first, you have a little bit more difficulty putting on the SSD holder. Something that is still the same from the last rig video is I am still using the FeelWorld MA5, but that's also being attached to the top handle with the small rig tilt and swivel. I do want to upgrade this eventually, even maybe if it's just a FeelWorld monitor. I know they came out with a pro version of this monitor, which I want to test out and potentially purchase. And so I may update this eventually, but I also am looking at the Blackmagic Assist or even the Atomos Ninja 5, simply because I can take those and record a compressed version of RAW on the Sigma FP, so it kind of has a dual purpose there. There's a lot of components that were on my rig before that are completely gone from this rig now. Things like the side handle, the Nucleus Nano, the mini matte box from Tilta. These are all things that are really awesome if you're trying to build out your rig. But the way that this is rigged out right now started to be the way I prefer to shoot, very minimalist. I felt like some of those things I put on the rig before just got in the way. For me, there's a balance of functionality versus just overkill. Now, sometimes I'll use the mini matte box if the project calls for it. I'll use the Nucleus Nano on my Crane 2S. I'll use it occasionally on the handheld rig, but not that often, and a lot of times on my shoulder rig. And so as far as the handheld rig, this is really what I found to be the best solution. Very minimalist compared to some rigs, and very well balanced. And when it's all said and done, I truly feel like a balanced rig is gonna get you better footage. So that's it for me. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to give it a like. If you're digging the overall content from the channel, consider subscribing. As always, thank you guys for joining. Go and find your journey. Go embrace life. Stay safe, be happy, support each other. Wash those hands, and I'll see you here next time. Peace.